So this year, the internship program under IDL, so already Manas has given two of the presentation, which is IoT and Arduino based system. The third project is going to be on 3D scanner. So hope everybody knows what exactly the 3D scanner is about. You heard about a 3D printer, if I'm not wrong. Okay, so how it prints a 3D thing? There's a SLT file, so by layer, it generates the 3D objects. Now, it's a reverse part, right? So I have an object, I want to scan the whole 360 degree and generate a mesh out of it. Now this mesh generated can be directly mapped with the texture and put it like a 3D object, or the same thing can be used again as a SLT to generate the 3D out of it. So for this, we are going to use this open source software and the hardware, which you can see, which uses a very simple tool based on Arduino. So we have one disk rotating, which is generally rotating with a stepper motor at 1 degree. As you can see, there are two pointers. So these are the laser pointers. And in center, there is a camera of it. So if an object is there, the laser straight line is coming out there. So, and the center camera is given, so it clicks a photograph. So with the laser, he can have the in and outs, the depths and out of the objects. So 1 degree it moves, again the photographs is taken from the camera. So each degree, so 360 degree, so whole object is covered, and you will have 360 images out of it. So all these 360 images are again taken into the further software here for the hours which is used to generate a 3D mesh out of it. Here, what exactly is required for this particular software is majorly the electronics people having knowledge of electronics and Arduino based controllers and image processing. So the whole tool is this software is purely based on Python and JavaScript. And this is the only hardware projects I'd say which is linked with the NVLayer project what we are going to have it. So out goal of this particular project is creating a, actually this is too dark, I'm not able to show you properly. We require two CS students also, where a virtual presentation is created, whatever the 3D objects is generated. So we have to make it as a virtual web also. So here, actually, it's not clear. It's totally in a dark room. So here, if I click on any of the object, so roughly you can see this is a 3D mesh generated object. So you can actually pan it and see, move it around. So whatever descriptions are there for that particular thing, you can just check it and pan it. This is the not the difficulty level is too high, but basic knowledge of Python and all the same, because this is already an open source, the codes are available. Why we require this? Because the objects which are generated, the 3D objects are generated, are not very clear. The software has to be tweaked so that we will have a lot of clear image at the output. So details, if I have a small object, if it is a solid box, yeah, it will do the things and give it. But if it has some curves in it or anything, so that is not been done properly. Okay, so we have to tweak with the software so that each and every point is captured. So this is the ultimate goal of this particular project. Okay, thanks.